If you ask 100 people what the worst font in the world is, you'd probably have at least 90 of them give you the same answer. There are overused fonts and ugly fonts, but the one that draws the most hate, the most abject disgust, is Comic Sans. For whatever reason, the typographically illiterate are drawn to Comic Sans for wide-ranging and often unintentionally hilarious purposes. From personal websites to homemade party invitations to gravestones, Comic Sans is everywhere. Some design-minded radicals have even called to ban the font, saying using it is akin to showing up at a black tie event in a clown costume. Comic Sans first materialized in 1995, designed for use in a Windows program called Microsoft Bob. The software was widely panned by critics and users, and was discontinued a year later, even receiving a slot in Time Magazine's 50 Worst Inventions list. Nevertheless, Comic Sans survived. While most of us can probably agree it's not a particularly pretty font, it does perform a very valuable service for millions of people. In this episode, we'll make the case for why Comic Sans is actually a very good thing. The history of Comic Sans makes a lot of sense. It feels like a rush job because it was. Back in 1994, Microsoft font designer Vincent Connor slapped the font together in just 3 days to get it ready for the release of the child-friendly Microsoft Bob software. It was loosely based on the lettering in the graphic novel Watchmen, but as one designer said, it has none of the fluidity you associate with the real thing. Later on, Comic Sans was incorporated into Microsoft Word, and the rest is history. People were attracted to the font because it seemed friendly and inviting. You started to see it on restaurant menus and in official emails. Even Connor agrees that the use of his font has gone a little overboard. He says, "I'm proud of it, but only because it suited its purpose at the time. We were trying to make a product, and Comic Sans suited the product. But I'd agree that it's often misused. I saw it recently in a bank, and that's not a great use of the font." Official business correspondence and bank advertisements might not be the right place to use Comic Sans, but believe it or not, it does have an appropriate usage, and that's to help people with dyslexia make sense of the written word. Dyslexia is a neurological learning disorder, often inherited, that makes it very difficult to discern between similar letters or numbers. Lowercase b and d, p and q, and the numbers 6 and 9 are common examples. It's suspected that up to 17% of the literate population struggles with some degree of dyslexia. That's millions of people. For those afflicted by the condition, deciphering written words can be an immensely frustrating task, and can hinder comprehension and enjoyment, often leading to an almost complete abandonment of reading. The main problem is that most fonts have what are called ambiguous characters, where one is often a mirror image or an upside-down version of another. Comic Sans, on the other hand, has unambiguous characters, easily discerned from one another thanks to slight variations in letter design. Comic Sans isn't the only font to do this. Several typefaces have been designed specifically to solve the issue of illegibility for dyslexic readers. The font Dyslexi uses letters that are heavily weighted at the bottom to keep them anchored to the baseline and reduce the risk of mentally reversing them. Another one is Selexiad, billed as an ongoing design investigation which began in 2001 and features a handwritten style, a feature often requested when surveying dyslexic readers. Here's the tough part. Studies have failed to show much correlation between dyslexia-specific fonts and greater legibility for dyslexic readers. More research is definitely required to establish just what it is about dyslexia that makes it so hard to distinguish letters and read at a normal pace. Despite the best efforts of dedicated designers, many dyslexic people still prefer to use Comic Sans, and often report that it's the most legible font they've tried. So, while many of us may snub Comic Sans as being childish or unprofessional, the font does perform a valuable service to millions of people around the world, and that has to count for something.